Welcome back for another interesting lesson on Simomatic, and now we will see how to interface S7-1200 real hardware PLC with OPC Way. Okay, one thing I want to mention here, you can also connect S7-1200 PLC without a real hardware. What do I mean? You can use PLC SIM and have a virtual PLC which you can connect to Simomatic. That's also possible, but in this example, I want to show you how you can make connection with a hardware PLC. All right, so same steps like codices. So first step is we understand the wiring. Second step, design the circuit. Third step, interface with Siemens PLC. Fourth step, simulate. And now here I'm designing an electro-pneumatic circuit. Very interesting, you can do so many things in Simomatic. So I want to show you first how the circuit looks like. This is my environment. So if I click on play, and if I press start, you can see the cylinder is going forward, then the second cylinder goes forward, then it comes back, and the first comes back. This is a small sequence, not so complicated. Cylinder going forward and reverse, following a sequence. And the interesting thing here is we have installed some read switches. If you see here, this is giving you a feedback if this is fully extracted or fully retracted in this case here. Okay, so these small read switches are used, which will give us a feedback about the positioning of the cylinder. Based on that, we will make a logic. And these cylinders are energized by this direction control valve. This is 5x3 valve, which are energized using an air compressor here in the bottom, and you can see a pressure gauge as well. So this whole pneumatic circuit you can download from this environment, which you will find in the public system, or I will put in the description in the video how you can do that. And then the most interesting part here is how to link with Siemens PLC. Okay, so let's go back to the first step as discussed here, understand the electro-pneumatic, and then further on I will tell you how to interface with a PLC. So in the diagram you will see here, this is my pneumatic circuit, and on the bottom you will see a control circuit. Okay, so what's happening in the pneumatic circuit? Let's see from the bottom. We have an air compressor. This air compressor is giving compressed air to PR01. What is PR01? It's a pressure relief valve, because this is used to control the pressure in the circuit. We need to control that. So by default, this air compressor is giving you 6 bars. If I want to show you that, if you go to my pneumatic system and you see AC01, this is my compressor. If I go to my info, I see an ideal pneumatic compressor providing 6 bar. Okay, we have 6 bar of pressure. And then this is connected to a PR01 pressure relief valve. What this valve is doing here, so I go to PR01 and you can set the pressure 5 bar. So this is the pressure setting you can do on this pressure relief valve. I can also change that. So right now this, you can also see, if I don't know if it's visible, this gauge, it's in the middle. So if I try to reduce it to 4, you can see it will move a little bit here. So this is now set at 4 bar. So if I click on PG01, you can see the value is 4 bar. So 4 bar is also an ideal pressure for small pneumatic applications. Okay, then after pressure relief valve, we have pressure gauge. We have seen that as well. And now the pressure, controlled pressure of 4 bar, is going to the input from here, and also from here to the input of my 5x3 solenoid valves. So I have 2 valves, and these 2 valves are here. This is my valve 1, this is my valve 2. Okay, so I have 2 valves. And what this valve is doing, what is inside this valve? So I've given some explanation here. So what happens? Let's come back here first. So this is my pressurized air coming here, okay? This is my pressurized air. And you can see that initially when the valve is not actuated, it's in the normal position, this is pressure is blocked. So what happens when you energize this valve? You can energize in 2 ways, because it says 5x3. Third part is the middle, in which there is nothing is happening. This is 1 way, 2nd way, or 3rd way, or you can call it 1 way, 2nd way, 3rd way. But the idea is there are 3 positions. In the middle position, nothing is happening, pressure is blocked. In this position, if this solenoid is actuated, what will happen? This will move. So I've explained that here. So when solenoid B is actuated, the valve will be in this position. In this case, pressurized air. So I've made this color. I can also make it here. So this was my pressurized air. I can make it blue. So at this position, the air is blocked. So when this is coming here, the air is going from inside to P4 and this P4 is here. So when B is energized, the pressurized air will come here. It will push the cylinder back. So the cylinder will go back. And in the another case, if A is energized, this solenoid is energized, this position will come. The pressurized air will go from here towards P2. And this P2 is connected to P1. This will push the cylinder forward. So in the simulation, we are just actuating and deactivating or changing the position of solenoid valve to move the cylinder forward and reverse. You have to be very careful with the wiring and connecting the pressurized air to the ports. This will change the whole operation. So I would recommend you can follow this diagram, and then you can do the wiring as explained in the diagram to build the circuit yourself, if you want to do things yourself, which I always recommend. All right, so similar way, both the cylinders are connected to these valves. And now what is this A, B, C, D, which are floating in this diagram? These are solenoids. So the solenoids are connected to the PLC. So these valves on off positions are controlled by a PLC. So if you see the second part of the diagram, and just to mention here one more time, the solenoids are actuated by 24 volts, okay? And on the top of the cylinder, you will see RS03, 04, 01, 02. These are the reed switches, which is giving a feedback to the PLC. So these reed switches are actually here, these orange devices, okay? So if I show you here, in cylinder 1 and cylinder 2. So if I maybe pause here, so cylinder 2 and this solenoid valve, so this is cylinder 2, so cylinder 1, this is my solenoid valve, and these are the connections here. So you can connect the connections as explained in the diagram. And, cylinder 1, for example, two inputs, P1 and P2, RS1 is the sensor here, and RS2 is the sensor here. So the cylinder 1 whole assembly is connected. I have bring it together in the assembly. Similarly, I have cylinder 2 with solenoid valve 2, cylinder 2, RS3, and RS4. Okay, so this is depicted here. Now, coming back to the control circuit, very similar to the last circuit, all you have to do is take a PLC. So in this example, I have my PLC. I have my PLC. My mouse is sometimes a bit strange. So that's the PLC here, and how this PLC is working with Siemens PLC. Let's have a look. So if I click on this PLC, you can see that it's much similar to Codis's PLC, which we were using in the last video. But here, you have to change the OPC URL. This is the URL which we get from the PLC. My PLC is connected with my computer via Ethernet cable. And there are some changes in input and output. So let's see step by step what we have to do. First thing, I will open my TI portal. So that's my TI portal where I have defined my PLC. So if I show you device and network, my PLC is located here. And the IP address is 192.168.0.146. That's the IP address. So let's go to the property of this PLC. So in the properties, what you have to do, there are several things you have to follow to build the connection. First thing is you go to DIATQ6. These are the input and output. So you go to IO address and you will remove this organization block, make it none. And everything is none because we don't have to read the inputs and give the outputs. Everything is done by OPC UA. So there doesn't make any sense to read the inputs. It's just wasted of scan time. And the next thing is you go down and go to your OPC UA. And if you see here, we have some settings. So if I go down, activate your OPC UA server. That's the first, second step. Here, once you activate that, you will automatically get a port number. And this URL is basically the IP address of your PLC plus the port address of OPC UA, which is by default 4840. And if you go down, you will find minimum sampling interval. Make sure it's 100 milliseconds. That you have to make sure. And if you go down, I have set the security to no security. I don't want any security in this example. And then if you see here, runtime licenses, it should be basic. So these are the settings to enable OPC UA in your Siemens PLC. Second thing, what you have to do is, the PLC which I'm using is S7-1200-1212C. In this case, my OPC UA has a separate folder. I can show you here, OPC UA communication. If I open this one, I will get a server interface by default. and I open and you click on add new server interface. In my case, I've added one and it's renamed as Simomatic. So if I open this, inside this you will see just two tags, inputs and outputs, and both are byte. This is similar to what we did in our codices example. Now, why these are byte? Because we are reading 8 bits from the PLC in Simomatic. So if you see here, you have 8 inputs and you have 8 outputs. So input is also a byte, output is also a byte. So take these two bytes, an input and output, in your OPC UI interface. So once you click add new interface, you can rename that, and then you will see this window. And from this window, I have defined these tags. You can go to program block, logic, sorry, not program block, but PLC tags, the tags are here, input and output. So these two tags I have defined in my PLC. So if I go to my PLC tag, show all tags, this is my input and output. So I just took these two tags and I drag that in my OPC UI like this, drag and drop. And then this is linked to your OPC UI interface. And then you can download the logic in the PLC. So PLC tags, this input and output will be linked to OPC UI tags. And you will read the information here, okay? So for example, if I show you PLC tags again, show all tags, and I go online, and forget this part at the moment, just check this input and output, you will see the values are coming here. These values are coming based on what is happening inside Simomatic. All right. Now, just because this whole byte has 8 inputs, so I have split this input in the Boolean form. So this whole byte, 10.0, 10.1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, these are my inputs. And similarly, so I can show you here based on addresses. Yeah, now 10.0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 10.0 is my cylinder 1 extracted. And how this is coming here, because if I see my first input connected to my PLC is RS1 signal. Okay, so if you see RS1, which is here, cylinder 1, RS1, this is my cylinder 1, this is RS1, this is extracted. Okay, if I want to show you this again, this is RS1. So cylinder 1 extracted is my first input to the PLC. Second input is RS2, which is this one, cylinder 1 retracted. So these inputs here, and then you have 10.2, 10.3, cylinder 2 extracted, 2 retracted, and this you can also see here. My first input is coming from RS1, second input RS02, RS03, RS04, then emergency stop, then start button, stop button, and reset button. Okay, these are the inputs which are linked in my PLC, and I just split this whole byte into individual bits to read the inputs. You can also do that. Similarly, for the output, I have 4 outputs for the solenoid valve, X21, 22, 21, 11. So here, this I can show you here. So my output is ABCD, and ABCD is here. So A is 21, 11, then 21, 11. So I think here is just a mistake in the number. 21, 11 and 21, 11. This is my solenoid 1 and that's my solenoid 2. Okay. You can write any name here. It doesn't matter. The only thing that matters is what are you connecting these addresses. And then you have 4 outputs. So that's how I have split my byte into individual bits, which makes it easy to program. And then I just have my main logic in which I have defined the sequence inside this logic. If I open it, that's my whole sequence about the cylinders. So what is happening, which at what time cylinder is extracting or retracting, there is this particular sequence. If you want, you can also have this logic and link with Simomatic. So what happens if I stop the logic? The sequence will stop. If I start the logic again, sequence will continue. So this logic is done in PLC programming. If you are new to PLC programming, you can join my PLC courses, which are available for basic and advanced level. So you can do that and you will learn how you can program the PLC. But anyways, here, so in this way, you can see how easy it is to link your PLC program by Siemens PLC to Simomatic via OPC UA. And you can also include e-stop here. For example, if I press e-stop, this is not going to run. If I release, and I have to reset because I activated blue light, and then it will first I reset and cylinder will go back to home position, and then I start again. Okay, so this is about how you can link your Siemens PLC with Simomatic. If you face any doubts or problem in interfacing, just write me a comment. One more important thing. Here you'll be wondering what I'm writing here as a value. So why I'm writing server interface.simomatic.inputs? Why I added this? I tell you the reason. So if you check this OPC UA via a software called UA Expert, which I generally use for OPC UA connections. So I connected my PLC. If I show you the properties, it's gonna be, that's my OPC UA address, and this is the address I got from my PLC. If I go to the properties and OPC UA, that's the address. Okay, you just enter the address in the software, you could be connected to the PLC. And now if you see this input and output, it's coming from server interface, Simomatic, and then inputs. Okay, this is same here. If I show you my OPC UA, communication is server interfaces, Simomatic, and then inputs. So here you will see there is a space between R and I. But if I check in UA Experts, there is no space. So that's why I refer you to use UA Experts, a free software. So you have to read the whole syntax to go to the input. So first you write server interface, then a dot, next folder, Simomatic, another dot, and then inputs. That's how you will connect to the inputs. Similarly for the outputs, server interface, another dot, Simomatic, dot, outputs. So if you see here, it is server interfaces, dot, Simomatic, dot, outputs. Be careful because of this lower and uppercase, it's very sensitive. So you have to make sure your I is uppercase, S is uppercase, and other are lowercase, as you have done here. Okay, or more precisely here. Follow the UA Expert. So that's how you have to put input variables, output variables, and the OPC UA address of your PLC, and press play, and make sure in this case, your gateway is running, because gateway is what which will connect your Simomatic environment with your PLC environment. Okay, so the gateway should be running and your server should be running anyways. So this was about how you can do electro-pneumatic circuit in Simomatic very easily. You can take this logic, take this environment, play around, make your own exercises, and feel free to share this with me. I'll be happy to see that. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next interesting video. Bye.